Uma ukhulele eningizimu kuphoqelekile ukuba ufunde engaphezulu kwesibili noma mfunda siqhathanisa isithathu.
Hello. Gentlemen, please, let us use this wonderful studio for a while. Get some rest. Have a cup of tea. Or two cups.
Uma ukhulele eningizimu phoqelekile ukuba ufunde engaphezulu kwesibili noma mhlawumbe ezini ngoba lapho
Thank you. This is so kind of you. What nice guys. You already know our new tutor, Professor Euclid. And today, he will give you his first lecture. Especially for this meeting, we borrowed from our latest cartoon, The Adventures of Buckery John Coney, this glamorous cave of a sorcerer, with magical attributes and a projector in the form of a crystal ball. Looks really cool. To begin with, I would ask you, dear professor, to make an expert assessment of the legendary video lessons by Eric Cartman, which we offer our students as a basic course for learning the fundamental principles of working in Adobe After Effects.
At the end of it, you'll be able to make your own little cartoon.
We are sometimes told that After Effects 7, in which Eric Cartman works, is already hopelessly outdated, and using it is impossible to learn anything. But the problem is that among our students, there are many residents of less developed countries who do not have opportunity to purchase a high-performance modern computer due to limited financial resources. They have to use for training rather old, low-performance systems. Taking into account the interest of such students, so that they also have opportunity to get involved in modern information technology, we continue to use in our lessons After Effects 7 wherever it possible. This version of After Effects is not very demanding on computing resources, and works fine on almost any computer. So let's ask Professor Euclid how relevant the lessons of Eric Cartman are, and can we still use them while learning the basics of After Effects?
Well, I see your point. Let's take a look. So, the video lessons of Eric Cartman.
The very first and the main panel is the project panel. You will assemble your cartoons of the various files that are stored somewhere on your computer.
At the very beginning, our fat-bellied friend introduces us to the program interface.
My God, Professor, you cannot call him fat-bellied. He's not fat. He's big-boned.
Okay. Our big-boned friend introduces us to the program interface. Let's compare the After Effects that Eric Cartman works with to what it has become today. So what do we see? The color has changed, of course, but color is just a color. We can change the color ourselves. What are the main elements of the interface that Eric told us about? First of all, the project panel. Personally, I don't see any significant changes here. Next, the timeline. The only thing that catches your eye is the edit search box. But in general, the basic elements remained unchanged. And finally, the viewer. It acquired additional features, but it has not changed its essence. It is still just a player that allows us to view our cartoon. And so, dear friends, I think a quick glance is enough to understand that the interface of Adobe After Effects has not changed significantly over the years. And even if you used After Effects 7 for beginners training, then literally 50 minutes will be enough for you to get used to and comfortably work in any, even the most modern version of After Effects. Therefore, I without a doubt recommend Eric Cartman's tutorials as a beginner's course in mastering the basics of After Effects, despite their venerable age. After all, good lessons are like a light wine. Over the years, they only become more valuable. Believe me, in my experience, for 2000 years, on my textbook Elements, entire generations of students have been learning the basics of mathematics. And I am sure that the lessons of Eric Cartman will not lose their relevance for many years to come, and they still have a long and fruitful life ahead of them. And to finally become sure of this, let us right now make a model of some cartoon character, guided by the instructions that Eric gives us in his lessons. And who are we going to make? Of course, we will create Winnie the Pooh. More precisely, it will be Winnie the Roo. That is, the Russian version of the beloved by everyone beer. We have already many times used this character in our cartoons. I look forward to see you in the next lesson.